With my depression, I ended up in the Royal Free because I was suicidal. And I was there for 3 weeks, and they looked after me very well. I was given an antidepressant. I can't remember which one it was at that particular stage. It made me feel a little bit better. And they just started me on cognitive therapy, which didn't work. I couldn't understand what they were talking about at that stage. I was very severely depressed. And I think the antidepressant helped me a bit. I'll come back to that in a moment. And then cognitive therapy. And cognitive therapy is, fortunately, nothing like psychoanalysis. What cognitive therapy is about is to try and help you get rid of all your negative views. One of the main features about depression is you have negative views about almost everything. And what the cognitive therapist tries to do is to show you that many of your negative views are wrong. So, for example, a classic example, not in my case, but where the therapist says, where the patient says, nobody loves me. And the therapist says, what about your dog? And the patient says, yes, my dog does love me. Now, you may think that that's trivial, but anything that makes you reconsider one of your negative things is a step forward in the right direction. And I know it's very difficult, but that's the way things can move forward. I did at one stage, at a much later stage, I had another depression after I'd recovered. And the person I was with said that she would not help me unless I had psychoanalysis. And so I went into psychoanalysis, and that didn't help me at all. And he said, you'll never recover without my help, at £94 a session. And fortunately, he went on holiday and I did leave. I didn't go back. But with psychoanalysis, you know, it's really psychobabble and it doesn't help at all. It's not like cognitive therapy at all. Cognitive therapy, you keep a diary. Keeping a diary is very important because, for example, the therapist can look at your diary and say, you keep saying you're never going to get better, but look, last Thursday you did feel better. And you say, gosh, really, I did feel a little better. And that does make one, you know, it does lead to improvement. And I began to get better with my depression. And I was very nervous about going back to work. And what I did with a cognitive therapist, we had a discussion as to what would happen. We sort of had almost like a little play that if I went back to work and felt back too bad at the meeting, what would happen if I walked out? And I realized it wouldn't be that bad. And I did go back and I didn't walk out. And if you make a step forward like that, then you're really on the way to getting better. And eventually my depression got better. And I've had minor recurrences over the years. And in fact, I've just come off my antidepressant. I've been off it for 2 weeks. Why do I want to come off my antidepressant? Like to know who I am, because it does cut you emotionally. I'm on I have been on a depressant called Effects or venlafaxine, and it does make one, it cuts one's emotions quite strongly. And I've been off it now, I came off it very slowly, and I've been off it for 2 weeks. I'm not doing too badly at the moment.